is your action? Where's my action?
And the Egyptian priests shave their heads.
Okay, so again, persecution.org, which is the website of International Christian Concern, please look for them on a search engine of your choice that doesn't spy on you. So on the 23rd of this of August, it's reported that within the space of 1 week, two activists in Iraq, in southern Iraq, have been murdered. They were assassinated, in fact, it's described as, and three more barely escaped murder, but presumably were severely hurt. Each of these events occurred in southern Iraq, as I just said, and came almost a month after the high-profile assassination of a scholar who specialised in paramilitary groups. These events have caused an outcry of alarm by many Iraqis who remember the frequency of targeted kidnappings and assassinations during the early 2000s. These latest series of events occur within a similar environment in that there is an increase of militia tension in Iraq's current domestic landscape. Many of these militias are heavily backed by Iran. So as some of you may or may not be aware, there are high tensions between the Muslims of both of those countries. The Christians, is something which is observed with concern and frustration. The assassinations of activists sends a clear message that speaking of human rights is intolerable by these militia. What I would say is Christ advocates strongly for the needy, the poor, those who are heavy laden. Activism within Islamic, dominated countries would include speaking out for apostates, praying for apostates, speaking out on behalf of Christians. As we know, recently Iran has invited its Christian community back. So Christians suffered significant human rights abuses, obviously, during the genocide carried out by ISIS, which is Islamic State in Syria, but IS is a more umbrella term. And the problems they currently face are largely driven by paramilitary factions. So it is all tied together, this militia, their murders, the assassinations of these people who are publicly speaking out against human rights abuses, which Christians are wont to do because we know that God loves each individual enough to die for them alone. So I'd like you, me personally, okay, would like you to please pray for the Christians in Iraq, in Iran, in Nigeria, in Pakistan, in North Korea, in China, in India. Like, I could literally stand here for the entire 6 hours and reel off, some from the heart, some from the top of my head, and some from my phone, countless cases of Christian persecution. If you are interested in this as a subject, and you join SoCo Films for £2.99, £3.99, or £17. On the Discord server that you receive free anyway, you'll be given access to a section of that server which is hourly updated with news of Christian persecution, Christian news in general, and jihad watch, basically, like looking for signs and symptoms and occurrences of jihad, which, for anybody who doesn't know, is not an internal struggle. It's based in the Quran, where it says, fight those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, nor the religion of truth. And basically, Jews and Christians fight them until they feel themselves humiliated and pay the jizya, which is like a protection racket kind of thing. So anyway, Iraq, please pray for those Christians there. Please also pray for Christians globally. When one of us suffers, we all suffer. And when there is joy in one, there is joy in many. So please do continue to pray. You don't have to give money. Prayer is far more valuable than money. You won't be asking for money on your deathbed. I guess you'll be asking for prayers or offering them up. So thank you again. Lots of love, etc. Always a pleasure. Never a chore. Love JC. Big up SoCo. Come and see me on Parler. Come and see him on Parler Discord. Just press a button, basically, and we are there. Like, en masse, for Jesus, every week, every day, etc. Lots of love. Bye.
This is God.